First of all, just what's your reaction to winning re-election?
You know what? Really excited. It justifies the enthusiasm that we continue to hear from doors, on phones, day in and day out about the work that we've been doing over the past 2 years. That stronger, more robust economy, finally funding national defense, passing an opioid package that will make a real difference in our communities. And I think that we heard resoundingly tonight that that's what Hoosiers wanted and that's what we delivered.
You talk about term limits. How many terms do you want?
I have signed a pledge to over 10,000 Hoosiers that I will serve no more than 8 years, because I believe four terms, as Gandhi said, in living the change you want to see in the world. And so,
what's one of the first things you want to do come this next term for you?
Well, look, we've done a lot of work on the economy, right? We've done a lot of work on national security, but the thing that I hear from Hoosiers every single day that they still want to see is that changing that culture in Washington, making sure we get back to a Washington that works for Hoosiers, for Americans, not for career politicians, is still the most important work I can do. So continuing my term limits efforts, right? Making sure I continue the strictest lobbying ban that's in existence in Congress that I authored, that's work that's really, really important to make sure we get back to that representative democracy where we can all talk in laudable terms about Washington, D.C. again.
How about immigration? Your opponent's spokesperson said that they were surprised at how that issue resonated, and frankly, they were probably flat-footed.
Right.
In terms of responding. Did you hear from voters as you campaigned this fall about that?
Every day. I heard about it on the phones. I heard it at doors. People want to solve the immigration issue. And that comes in twofold, right? One, how do we make sure that people want to come here to this country, but they come here legally to share in the opportunities, the abundance that America has to offer? But how do we, at the same time, stop people from coming here illegally? It's what I heard about every single day. And it's exactly what I campaigned on in 2016. And it's exactly what I want to continue to work on alongside the president.
What do you want? What specifically do you want to see? Do you want the wall?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. I believe that we need to ensure that we stop people from coming here illegally and we reform the legal immigration system so that we get to better outcomes for those people that do want to come here and create better opportunities for themselves, and thus we will all live better lives because of it.
What do you think was the single defining issue in this campaign?
Look, I think it came down to something really, really simple, right? Who matches our values, right? That's what voters ask themselves, right? Who's working for us? And I think what we heard tonight, what we saw tonight, is that Liz Watson didn't match their values, but my work in Congress, my votes in Congress, my continued work in our communities match their values. The change that they've seen over the past 2 years is the change that they want to continue over the next 2 years. And I'm deeply honored and humbled by the opportunity to continue to work on Hoosiers' behalf, and we will continue to fight for a Washington that they can believe in and that they deserve.
What are you going to do to help heal the divisiveness that's happening across the country politically?
It's a great question, right? One of the things that I pride myself on is I've gotten more bipartisan bills out of committee than any other member of committee, because I believe that we ought to solve problems, right? That we have got to get to better outcomes for Americans. Now, Republicans don't have a monopoly on great ideas. Democrats don't have a monopoly on great ideas. I want to work with anybody and everybody that has a great idea to help a Hoosier, right? To advance Hoosier interests. That's what I'm first and foremost focused on.
Have you spoken to Liz?
I have not. I've not heard from her yet.
Anything else you want to say?
No, I think that's it. Thank you guys for coming out tonight.
Thank
I really
you.
Appreciate it. Absolutely.
Thank you. We appreciate it.